I see a certain kind of mad genius in Germinio. He and his work are an expression of an always searching mind and spirit. From as early as the mid-1970s, Germinio's been experimenting with found objects, discarded pieces of society and nature, assembling them into pieces of fine art.
No, I recycle leftover of the society of the nature.
I mean, it's experimentation, but he actively and unapologetically synthesizes something.
And what are you looking for with this stuff? What are you trying to do? Like, what are you looking for?
So these are cross that I'm ripping up from the walls. So it's like material. I go home, I continue to destroy those pieces in small pieces of paper. And after, I put all together, creating what I think this kind of this kind of a poetry of colors. Look how beautiful they look here.
For me, what I do, I don't glue it the first place because I don't want to give it only right away the maturity. No, I leave at least a gap of time that allowed me to review and consent what I did earlier, change or because after I glue and nobody moves, you know?
It is removed from what would be termed to be, by definition, a collage. It has also a grandfather, if you want to speak that way, which is in the 60s, artist in Italy and in France, in Paris, what it was known as décollage. Décollage meant that the artist would lift, literally, a poster and then replace it or put it back as it lifted from the billboard onto a canvas.
This work was recently acknowledged by the Italian Institute of Culture in Toronto, Canada, with an exhibition of his work in the summer of 2001. Germinio is one of the first Italian-Canadian artists to be featured by this prestigious institution.
See, this I like very much, see this one? This is a nice piece. So, I like it. See, this is a nice piece. Really nice piece, this.
with Politi. Germinio studies in Italy, is entrenched in the classical style, but obviously he moves on, like all artists, into the cognitive element.
He's incredibly eclectic in his ability to use various different materials, some with long established histories and genealogies and documentaries, and others that he just makes up himself.
I use everything he's available, from the nature, even from our consumistic society.
Germinio was born in 1953 in Brindisi, Italy, the second of three children to Felice and Ada Politi. His family would move to Taranto in southern Italy in 1959.
I was a kid, I was looking with a certain kind of interest, of looking 360. No? I was more attracted from the form, from the contour, by the color.
Lui vedeva l'arte già da ragazzo, a una pietra, a un legno particolare. Vedeva già qualcosa lì, che noi magari diciamo, ma è un legno vecchio, di poter. Invece lui vedeva già qualcosa là dentro.
Germinio would come of age with the rise of the Italian student movement in the late 1960s. It was a volatile time for Italian society, marked by massive street demonstrations, social unrest, and the appearance of groups such as the Red Brigade. This upheaval directly influenced Germinio's early artistic experimentations and can be seen still in his continuing need to express his thoughts and feelings. The following years would be a physical and emotional roller coaster, one that would, in 1979, hurdle Germinio and his fiancée Laura Albanese to Toronto, Canada, where they would be married on January 3rd. He began to feed off his new environment and venture into the cultural conversation of this new land. Canada gave Politi the chance to reinvent himself in a country outside of the societal norms of Europe.
My work is a work like, as I say in Italian, of un fiume carsico, that a carsic river that is already difficult following his way to the sea in the surface, because it goes, right, left, curves a lot, but carsic because after a while it goes inside the ground, so you don't know where the branches and the way it goes.
Se non essere mai prigioniero del tuo stile o mai prigioniero di te stesso e né prigioniero delle cose buone. Sono sempre diverso perché le mie emozioni sono sempre diverse e le persone che incontro sono sempre diverse e i colori che vedo sono sempre diversi. Quindi la diversità, io penso, è quello che fa capire oggi il mondo di oggi.
From the figurative to the abstract, from paintings to sculpture, While the medium may often change, what remains constant is Germinio's almost manic drive to express himself.
Why? I tell you why.
In 1977, Germinio was a passenger in this 1960 Alfa Romeo Sprint, being driven by a close friend. As it rounded a bend, the car left the road, struck a tree, and stumbled down a steep embankment, killing the driver and leaving Germinio in a coma for 7 days. This is just one of more than 7 serious accidents Germinio has survived since the very first one at the age of 9 years old.
First one was 9 years and a half old. I was hit by a car.
My work started in a very strange setting. I was in the hospital, this private room, and at that time I drew a red and Madonna with the Bambino.
Germinio's work began in pain, and pain has been a constant reminder to him of the intensity and unpredictability of life.
There are no words to describe that kind of situation.
He's suffering, you know?
Healing, suffering, trauma, post-trauma, and all the complications of bones, because as a result of those accidents, because it's long to make the list of all of them, but it's 23 bones broken, more than 600 stitches, and 7 days coma, and a life lived 100% at 360 degrees.
He has learned to embrace the unpredictable and chaotic in life as well as in the way he approaches his work. An excellent example of that can be seen in his fire, alcohol, and water technique. A technique he began in his mother's kitchen through experimentation with household products like bleach and cleaners. In this process, random variables were embraced and celebrated. This work was included in 2 major exhibitions in Italy in the 1980s. One in the ex-convent of San Rocco in Carpi, and the other in Spoleto, the home of the Festival of the Two Worlds and a focal point for many art connoisseurs. Germinio's ample struggles have made him very sensitive to the struggles of others. In the early 1990s, Germinio was instrumental in developing a curriculum for teaching art to mentally disabled individuals as a way for them to express themselves. He also helped to organize one of the first exhibitions of art by mentally disabled adults in North America. So much chaos and struggle has often driven Germinio to seek solace in open spaces, whether they be imaginary landscapes of his mind or the physical landscapes beyond the control of human society. Wow.
them went down to get all of them, but they ended up with none of them. When some of them wanted all of them got none of them, no, none of them. So all of them tried to get some of them, and even then they got none of them. Some of them, no, none of them. Some of them, no, none again, none of them. Some of them, no, none of them, no. Some of them, no, none of them, none of them.
When you work, you have to be in a status of mind. You, it's a work, working, you know, creating. But it's a work that needs a passion, you know. You have to feel that. If you don't feel that, they become a mechanical work. So let's be artisan, you know. You see only mind and hand, instead of mind, hand and heart.
The lady, no profile, the eye, the nose. You don't see the nose, but now I show the team that is going around and they say, "Hi, my dear, I love you. Hi." See, we found the two people that they love, they kiss. Hi. I love you. You know, it's very easy because if you are in harmony, you know, everything is possible. But you have to discover this kind of dimension in seeing things that don't exist. But everything exists.
I think that's the way he sort of looks at nature. It's just so much order and symmetry and harmony. And in his mind, he feels like there's some sort of personal world spirit behind it all.
My mother, that means the society, the nature. I need to be in harmony with nature and spend some time in the nature.
For Germinio, the wilderness represents solitude and vastness and is a perfect contrast to the crowded social realities of modern urban living.
And he's not the type of guy that hikes through quickly. He walks slowly, you know, he samples everything with his hands.
Fits perfectly.
You know, I don't know if it's even possible to use avant-garde anymore in these times with art, right? But he's always, you know, thinking of new ways, even within just the medium that's already been used by thousands of artists for 1,000 years. You know, like this belief in this infinity of expression with these discrete set of constraints. And at the same time, you know, he's willing to use a blade of grass if that'll do it.